That definitely. They're not going to stick around. Hopefully they're not going to stick around if that's the case. I see Coach Tad over here nodding. Do you know anything about that?
Yeah, no. Can you hear me okay? I think my headphones may be out.
No, you're good.
Sorry, yeah, I completely agree. I think that what you'll have is sometimes that you have the guys that are on the other end of the promotion that are doing the promoting that are maybe more interested in the franchising aspect or that. And then you have the guys that, like you say, they're not putting in the mat time. They're not getting out there testing themselves. And then as they move up into the promotion, then they're going to be next in line to open up the satellite school wherever, and then just kind of, you know, promote going for sort of this idea of growing the business. And, you know, I guess another follow-up question I'll ask you is for, you know, if anybody's listening, like what are, you know, because like you say, if you're sort of insulated, it's hard to recognize what you're doing. If you start up in an academy, how is a person who doesn't know, you know, what you know, supposed to identify, maybe I need to open up and look around a little bit more?
Yeah, that is very difficult. I think, you know, if you have somebody that's trained, they, you know, for a while and they move into the area, they know right away. But if you are a, sort of a person that just, you know what, I've heard a lot about Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, let me try it out. They don't know. And they may never know. You know, here's the reality. Any martial art, any physical fitness, any physical movement is good. There are just forms or schools that are better than others. But, you know, your average practitioner, they won't know. It's going to be difficult. You just hope that they have a good experience to the point where, you know, if people are smart and they kind of, you know, start to evolve and they get technically good and, you know, they might realize, you know what, you know, maybe the coach does not necessarily have to be the greatest physical specimen, but okay, I understand he knows what he's talking about, but sometimes they don't even know what they're talking about. And if they are educated and they sort of start to say, you know what, maybe this guy doesn't know what he's talking about. Maybe I need to look for a more technical school, a school that's going to take me to the next level. That's fine. But a lot of people, you know, do martial arts and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu for a variety of reasons. And you don't necessarily have to be in the best school to thrive. So it's sort of a little bit of a, you know, two sides of the same coin where, you know, a guy is making claims and sort of has accolades or whatever that probably, you know, within a different tribe he wouldn't have, or, you know, he'd be way lower ranked. But does that mean that he's bad for Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu? Not necessarily. Depending if he's a good teacher, he cares about his students, tries to continually grow. That's not necessarily bad. What I think are bad is the guys that, you know, first of all, exaggerate their credentials. I don't like people when they take shortcuts, because they will, by definition, they will not be the best. And also that take a very poor attitude towards growing their students, you know, making sure that they get technically better, that they grow, because, you know, different people have different needs, and that they grow, you know, that they help guide them according to their needs, you know, where guys just, you know, that was a YouTube from Huron or Henner recently, where, you know, a guy just went into, you know, he wanted a school that's cheaper and closer to his house. He wind up some school, they throw him on the mat. It's like, hey, you want to roll, bro? And he's like, I didn't know what to do. And, you know, I'm here, I'm trying to fend for my life. And, you know, and basically the guy feels like he's under, you know, somebody's trying to beat him up. That's not a school. You know, and this is one of my pet peeves again, you know, like where I don't refer to my schools ever as gyms. When you go to gym, you lift weights, nobody cares about you, and you go home. This is a school where we try to guide people and we obviously teach them technique, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu technique. But if you're an instructor, you really do need to instruct, and you need to try to make sure that you take care of your students. And that doesn't mean, you know, taking a new guy and throwing him into the mix, say, hey, listen, here's some new guy, go, you know, beat the piss out of him.